Yo! What's up? This is Patrick.
This is Stijn.
And in this video, we're going to show you how to create facts and dimensions in your lake database. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. Stijn, it's been a journey. We've been through the bronze layer where we got the raw data, went to the silver layer where we initiated this thing called Delta. But now, you know, I'm a Power BI guy and I need some stuff that I can connect to so I can start doing some reporting and some analytics and kind of getting intimate with my data. And so now it's time to go to the gold layer. Why don't you tell us about that?
Today is all about the gold layer, which basically means we're going to add business value to the data that we have in our silver layer. Our silver layer is quite close to the source, while we're now going to go and create our facts, our dimensions, and things that we can query and build reports on and do an analysis on that data. We're going to do it the same like we did before. We're going to use a notebook and basically just select the data that we need and make sure that we can connect the data to each other. And out of that gold layer, you can then connect your Power BI. You can query it with SQL, whatever you want to do with it.
So, all right.
Enough talking, let's head over to my laptop.
All right, let's head to your laptop.
We're back into my Azure Synapse Analytic workspace, and today we're going to head over to the Develop tab. Over here, you can see that we have on our Guide queue a notebook that we created, which is called Initialize Dimensional Model. So what I'm going to do here, first of all, I'm going to load in my silver layer with the taxi data. I'm going to display 10 rows. You can see we've got all these different rows in there, and it's a very wide table. And I just basically want to have one fact and one dimension out of it. I'm going to create and replace a temp view to make it accessible into the SQL language in my Spark. As you can see here, I can select from it. And now we're going to scroll a little bit down, and I'm going to create a lake database. So the lake database you can see here is called Create Database Gold Layer. And that lake database will be visible inside my data tabs, but more on that later. So what I'm going to do now is I will go and create a fact in a dimension. So I will create a table using Delta because we need to be able to insert, update, and delete data to that fact table. I'm specifying the location, which is gold, Delta, fact, sales. And I'm just selecting from that data frame that I loaded the few columns that I need, which provide me business value. And you can see here that I have a vendor ID, and I would like to have a dimension out of that one. So what I'm doing here is I'm just creating another table using Delta called dimension vendor. And I'll just add in here the vendor ID. I'll make a bogus name for that vendor, and also adding SCD type in here.
Okay, so we are actually building facts and dimensions in the lake database, just like if I was using a regular SQL server or a dedicated SQL pool. Am I gonna persist that data to these tables?
It's not persisted in the tables as such, but the tables reference a folder, and that's a Delta table. So it's the framework of Delta. It has a folder structure and it has the data in there. It's not like you have a relational database like in a SQL DB where it would be stored in your MDF file.
Yeah.
No, it's actually a folder that you're referencing using that lake data.
Beautiful, beautiful. But I get the advantages of ACID, right? So my data is autonomous, it's consistent, and all those things, right? So I can do inserts and updates in this without actually building a full relational database. This is crazy. This is bananas. Now, let me ask you this. So once we do this, am I able to connect to this?
Yes, you can.
All right.
As you can see, I've created these two tables. And if we now head over to the data tab over here, you can see that we have that gold layer. And we've got these tables here. Now there's a super cool thing inside Synapse, which is called serverless SQL pools. And this can be used to just query this. So I'll just right click here, new SQL script, select top 100 rows. I want every column here. You can see it's using this built-in. I've got a tree part name, which is something you can just query and combine different lake databases with serverless databases together. Just run this, and this will just give me the query, as you can see here, and this is querying that lake database. This is a SQL endpoint, which means that Power BI can just connect to it and you can show whatever you want to show with your data.
So you're telling me I can query just about any type of data. I can query Delta, I can query CSV, I can query just about whatever I want over this serverless SQL pool. See, over this serverless SQL pool.
Indeed, serverless SQL pool basically is a sort of an MPP system, which is on demand. You just pay for the query that you're executing.
Wow.
And you can query a variety of different types of files or folders. And that folder that we have now is basically just a reference to that folder. We can just say, hey, just get me the data from that folder. It will automatically execute the query, optimize that query, and then just give you the results.
Wow, wow. This is bananas. This is bananas. So we went on our journey. We took the raw data, then we cleaned it up, and we made it this Delta format. And now we have our goal layer. We can actually use Power BI to connect to this serverless endpoint. And I'm going to show you guys this in a video, on a Wednesday video. I'm going to show you this. And now we can query our fact tables and our dimension tables directly with Power BI. So now I got questions. You mentioned this SCD thing, this slowly changed dimension. We're not going to talk about that today. You got to stay tuned for another video. All right. If you have any questions about this, any comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam,
Ben,
and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video. Boo.